I'd like to show you this tweet from Elon Musk. It is a meme. It's a meme of me. And boy, did this one trigger a lot of people.
Oh, man.
But it's not so much about the meme. I do want to highlight. It shows me say, here's an example of Twitter's left-wing bias. Twitter says we need to take into consideration the context. Me then saying the context is affected by your bias. And then Twitter saying we need an example of that. And the cycle continues. And I give you another example.
Well, Tim, do people understand that this actually comes from your appearance with her on Joe Rogan? Because I actually think people may not understand the context.
Well, I think a lot of people don't understand that this is just summarizing. I went on Joe Rogan. Man, this comes up a lot now because this keeps becoming relevant. And we had this conversation.
Dude, that was huge.
Yeah. Let me help you guys understand, because this tweet's got 34,000 retweets. What does this tweet mean? During the show, I was sitting down with Joe Rogan, Vijaya Gadde, the top lawyer, the one who reportedly cried at a meeting, and Jack Dorsey, the former CEO. I said, you have banned many people for saying hashtag learn to code. That is an example of your bias. Vijaya Gadde said, yes, but you need to take into consideration the context. They were saying that to harass people. I responded with, no, they weren't. That your interpretation of that is based on fake news and leftist biased media. And she said, I would need to see an example of that. To which I responded, here's an example. You suspended right. The editor-in-chief of the Daily Caller for indirectly saying learn to code in a quote tweet. He didn't tweet it at anybody. I'm pretty sure that's what happened, right? He didn't tweet it. He didn't direct it at anybody. He was like,
no, I don't think it was even a quote tweet. It was just a standalone tweet.
And they suspended him for it.
That's right.
And there were many other people who did not direct learn to code. So I say that to her. And then, well, you got to take into consideration that. So that was a mistake. But the context around it. Okay, here's another person who tweeted a blanket thing like people are saying learn to code and it's funny, banned. So this cycle goes on and on. In this tweet, though, I want to show you some other things, because what this really is about, this is about some shady goings on. We talked about this yesterday, but I think we have a mystery, my friends. Take a look at Twitter. Let's pull up the tweet again. On the right side, what is this? Skateboarding is trending.
What?
Now, Tim Pool is trending. Okay, I can't do anything about that. Elon Musk tweeted me out. But skateboarding, Dodgers at Diamondbacks? Now that's interesting. Now this, it says the black phone is trending, that's promoted. The What's Happening tab for me, maybe many of you have noticed this, has been consistently and overtly political, and it's typically leftist politics. It's typically saying something about, you know, it'll say, Joe Biden did not shake hands with thin air, according to fact checkers. That's always what's going on in my What's Happening. Yeah. All of a sudden, it's like, you like skateboarding, Tim? Well, I actually do like skateboarding, but you've never recommended that to me before. Something strange is going on. And when you look at some of these tweets, let me see if I'll pull this one up right here. Daily Mail reports, burning the evidence before the new boss starts. Don Jr. and right-wingers see giant leaps in their Twitter followers after Musk bid was accepted. Let me see if I can pull up this tweet, because I might have things out of order. This is a tweet from me referencing the red-headed libertarian, a good friend of the show, Josie. Her Twitter handle is at @TRHLOfficial. That account was abruptly suspended January 20th, 2021, after she pointed out that in January 9th, 2019, she predicted Joe Biden would run for president and Kamala Harris would be the VP. A year later, with no warning, for no reason, she got suspended. That's it. She didn't break any rules. Why did that happen? Well, just, I believe it was today, she received an email. Abruptly, they reinstated her account. Why? It is obvious at this point that the drop-off of progressives, their follower counts are collapsing and conservatives are rising. It is not organic. Twitter is lying. There are journalists in the press claiming Twitter says it's organic. They're assisting in the lie.
Well, I think what they're doing is they're playing a game of saying it's organic because it's not bots. So it's not bot activity. Yes, it is real people that are leaving. A lot of progressives are leaving. A lot of conservatives are coming back. But the activity is not organic. The activity is artificial, because this is the ban hammer which had swung down on people like Josie, people like so many others that are getting these. Now it's being lifted and they're magically coming back.
I don't think progressives are leaving. Sean King wouldn't even leave. You know, he deactivates his account.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Sean King did leave for like 12 hours.
Yeah. Right, but I mean, he came back.
And then he came back. And then he pretended like he didn't leave.
And then they were trying to call you out, Jack, as if
right, and then he was trying to call me out as if I'd made it up. And it's like, bro, we all saw you take your account down.
I'm going to say it. I'm looking for the simple solution here.
Right.
I'm trying to make the least amount of assumptions. So when I see, you take a look at the Social Blade analytics.
Yeah.
Monday was the day that Elon Musk, it was announced, would purchase Twitter at 2:53 p.m. I know because I was recording live. I do all my recordings from my main show live. And at 2:53, the tweet comes out.
Yeah.
Okay. So you mean to tell me the day at 8 in the morning when the Wall Street Journal announced Elon Musk was in negotiations with Twitter.
Like final negotiations.
Final negotiations. Yeah. It was 8 a.m. Not a single conservative said, I'm going to come to Twitter and gloat. Not a single one came and said, let's cheer this on. Not a single leftist said, I'm going to leave. This is getting dangerous. Okay, fine. Maybe, because it hadn't happened yet. By 2:53 p.m., not a single conservative joined Twitter to tweet, we got it, baby. Not a single one. Not a single progressive said, I'm leaving. I can't believe this just happened. No, they all just, for some reason, waited 24 hours.